Hey out there, it's Wake Angel 2001 again. Sorry if I appear a little bit gaunt, I just got home from work again and found that a couple more packages have been sent to me. Yep, two of them this time. And no, I did not get locked in my job again. That's not going to happen twice in a row. Although, it was quite the little conversation piece at work today. Okay, so... Social Media Menace Eric. Box 2 of 2. Alright, so it's possible that both of these boxes were sent to me by the same person, although the first one doesn't have any handwritten thing on the side like that. Benton and Jacob. Yeah, these definitely came from two different people, although they might have been ordered by the same guy. I don't know. So, let us get these packages open and find out what's in them. Whoosh. Okay, in. I will get that. Look, come on. Come on, there we go. Okay, cutting through some tape. Getting into the habit of cutting away from the body so as not to stab self. Alright. Ah, there's a letter here. Social Media Menace Eric, box 1 of 2. I was hoping you could use the hands and feet and possibly the body as the base for the figure. I wanted Jazzwar's arms and legs to have some consistency with the rest of the classic line, if not just the hands and feet. Thank you. Okay, so this was definitely sent to me to customize. Bunch of bags in here. Okay. There is a Sonic figure in here. Okay. Come on. I can see it's a Knuckles figure, but through all the bubble wrap, I can't see which Knuckles figure. Come on. Come on. Boop. It is the Jax Pacific Knuckles, the 2.5-inch line one. I should remind everybody that, that... These are not compatible with Jazzwares figure parts. You can't pull off, like, limbs from a Jazzwares figure and stick them into these things, or vice versa. It has to do with the way the torsos are built. They're made out of a hard plastic. You can't pull the pindus out of... Yeah, it's, So, yeah, I'm not sure what I'm gonna make with this. I've kind of forgotten, but when I get back to Social Media Menace, we'll find out. Okay. Yeah. So, what's in the second box, then? Yes, we are seeing what is in the second box. No one will be exceeded during the riveting tape-cutting scene. And in here is... the Tokaku Collection Classic Knuckles figure. Okay, now I know what I'm supposed to do. I'm supposed to take this guy, and somehow combine them together into an articulated Classic Knuckles figure to scale with the Jazzwares Classic Knuckles figure. I am completely certain that I told him not to send the Jax Knuckles for this task. Unless I'm just using hands and feet. Yeah. Okay. Okay, so I think I'm just sticking this guy's head on this guy's body, which might be feasible to make a classic Knuckles. Although, like, in the classic style... I'm not sure you want the feet to be like that. I don't know. I'll take some pictures. We'll do some comparisons. We'll try to see if we can work something out. Cause I don't think that it's as simple as sticking a bigger head onto the classic body to make a classic character. I mean, maybe since it's the Jazzwares classics, those are inherently bigger. Except that they're 2.5 inches tall, so they would be this height. Hold on. I am never When I'm on my workspace, I'm never more than a few feet away from my almost my entire Sonic the Hedgehog collection. Okay, so here is Jazzwares' classic Sonic figure. The Jazzwares classic Sonic is exactly the same height. You can't see behind the label, but I do have their feet lined up. Exactly the same height as the modern Knuckles figure made in the 2.5 inch line by Jack Specific. And yes, he actually is also exactly the same height as this little statue. When I line them up, you can... Yeah. See? Exactly the same height. So, this scales perfectly as a classic Knuckles next to the Jazzwares classic figures. Only problem is that it's a statue and not a figure. It has no poseability or articulation of any kind. So, yes. I'm not sure what I'm doing here. I don't know. Adding articulation to a statue or, I don't know, modifying something. I'm not completely sure what I'm going to do. I'll do something. Figure something out. We'll work this out. If anything, like you know, this is classic Knuckles. Like, the size of his hands and feet are the proportions that a classic Knuckles character is meant to be. Like, I don't think you should put, like, the hands and feet of a modern Knuckles figure, which are, funnily enough, they're proportionally bigger. Like, the classic Sonic characters, their feet and hands are proportionally smaller when you compare them to their modern counterparts, but Knuckles is the exception to that. Like, his classic version has smaller feet and hands, and they got bigger when he, in proportion to his body, when he got modernized. I'm pretty sure he's the only character that did that of the whole collection. I'm thinking, Sonic, Knuckles, Tails, Amy, everybody else, like, everybody gets physically taller in proportion to their body size. Their heads are slightly smaller in proportion to their body, and also their hands and feet get smaller. Like, it depends, like, the hands and feet get bigger. I don't know. I don't know what I'm talking about. I'm talking about my butt here. I don't know what I'm talking about. I'm not sure. Whatever. I think I can make this work. I'm not 100%, but we'll figure something out. I've taken a classic Knuckles head from a statue, put it onto a modern body, and made a classic Knuckles figure articulated before. I only did it the one time, and I used those I think I still have them. Like, I really am never more than a few feet away from anything that I ever need to reference, am I? Not yet. This very set. In fact, you can see what's left of the Knuckles figure that I use. Way back in the day, I took that Knuckles' head off, stuck it onto a torso, and I used the truncated limbs of the Free Rider's Knuckles figure, which I never saw. Like, the Free Rider's Knuckles figure apparently is a thing that existed, but it was so hard to find, I never found it. Despite the fact that at the time it was released, I did work at Toys R Us. So, like, I would have had the hookup on any of these, never saw them. I never saw the Knuckles figure for the Free Rider's line. I wasn't even sure if it was released. I thought it was something that they said was gonna be released but got canceled, but somebody sent me a parts bin once, and in there were the parts to make the Free Rider's Knuckles arms and legs, like his forearms and his shins. They were in there. The rest of the figure wasn't there, only the forearms and shins, and I used those to make the classic Knuckles figure. I never saw the actual Free Rider's Knuckles. That's the only hint that I ever had that anybody ever had one. So, yeah. Like, if you want to ask, hey, are there any action figures of Sonic the Hedgehog that Wake Angel 2001 was never able to find? The Free Rider's Knuckles figure was definitely one of them. That being said, those are the only shortened limbs that are natively red. I suppose, like, any of the characters that have the bicep and knee swivels, if you if you just pluck those off, they'd be the right length, and then I could paint them red. But yeah, those were the only parts that were actually red by design. He says as he looks up at the shelf where all of his action figures are displayed, just to make sure. And yes, I am correct. None of them have red limbs except for Knuckles himself. Okay, so I think we've gone on long enough about this task. I actually do have another custom video to edit right now, so I'm gonna go ahead and get to editing that. This is Wake Angel 2001. We'll see each other next time.